Why is it that organizations so often struggle to use the tools and processes that we would all agree are good things to do? And the answer to that question starts with the notion of capability. And capability is just shorthand for anything that your organization needs to be good at in order to realize its competitive position. So if you're a customer-focused organization, a lot of your capability resides in the heads of your customer service representatives and their ability to satisfy those customers. Capabilities tend not to change right away, meaning that if you want to raise the capability of your organization, it typically takes time. And if you quit investing in capability, it takes time to drain out of your organization. So imagine you ran a manufacturing operation with lots of equipment. If I made the decision today to fire all my maintenance mechanics, all my equipment doesn't break tomorrow. I'm going to have to run that equipment for quite a while before that capability will eventually dissipate. On the flip side, if I want to raise capability, I tend also not to get the benefits right away. It takes time for that vessel of capability to accumulate. So imagine that you're getting to the end of whatever your fiscal year is, and you're a little bit behind on whatever you're supposed to be producing. What might you do? Well, in many cases, we will find a way to basically skimp in the short run on capability and redirect the energy that would normally go to capability into producing some more results. So, as an example, if we go back to the factory again, I might delay some planned maintenance so I could make a few more widgets. But when we do this, what tends to happen is in the short run, performance actually improves. And the reason it improves, of course, is because in some sense I can harvest the investments and capability I've already made, and I get this little honeymoon period where there's an initial boost in performance. Now, if I continue that strategy and don't make appropriate investments in capability, eventually performance will decline, but only after that initial boost. We tend to be fabulous learners as long as there's a short time delay between taking an action and getting an outcome. If I hit the brake pedal in my car slows down right away. I learn very quickly to sort of modulate the speed of my car. In contrast to this, however, when there's a long time delay, it is much harder for us to learn that those two things are connected. And my favorite example of this is broccoli. We all know that vegetables are good for us and good for our kids, but getting your children to eat their vegetables can be an enormous challenge sometimes. Well, if you think about it, what do your kids get from eating their vegetables? Well, in the long run, they're going to be happier and healthier, but that benefit only comes with a very long time delay. So go back to the scenario that we started with. I make a decision to reduce my investment in capability and increase my investment in short-term performance. The first thing that happens is things get better. In contrast, however, in the long run, things eventually get worse. But that only happens with a delay. And in that situation, it's much harder for us to learn to connect the decision I make today with the problem that I might only experience weeks, months, or even years later. So we call this phenomenon the capability trap. And the idea is that I can often meet my short-term targets by focusing more on work and less on capability. But if I'm not careful, I learn exactly the wrong lesson as to what drives the performance of my organization, and I can find myself stuck in this trap of low capability where I'm working super hard all day, every day, trying to deliver my targets, but I never have time to make the investments in capability that would get me out of that trap and lead to improved performance.